Well, assuming the men in the room are done mansplaining around this issue, I will have an opportunity to talk about today why I think the Reproductive Health Act not only is germane, but fundamental to the responsibilities of this House. The underlying bill deals with torture of animals. I would argue that New York State laws are so antiquated that they are resulting in women risking their lives and some cases dying because we don't have the right law on the books. And surely that is germane if you're concerned about torture. Because if you're concerned about torturing animals, you should also be concerned about the torture and death and cruelty to the women of the state of New York. Our laws are in conflict with federal law since 1973. They are inconsistent with and fall short of the constitutional protections of Roe and its progeny, but remain in the books of New York because this House refuses to modernize our laws. If Roe v. Wade were to be overturned, New York's current law would make it illegal to perform an abortion after 24 weeks, even if the mother's health is in danger. And in fact, under existing law, women are having to leave New York State to go in search of doctors and hospitals who are providing life-saving late-term abortions when nowhere in New York can they get these services and treatments. And Mr. President, women are dying because they can't get the health care they need in time. And Mr. President, New York State falls behind many other states who have, in a bipartisan way, modernized their laws to ensure that they have the right protections for women's health. Our laws are limiting the pool of available providers. Our laws are making it difficult for women in many counties of the state to get the care they need and to find providers. This amendment would correct and address these issues by updating our existing reproductive rights laws in a way that frees the state from attacks on access to the full range of safe reproductive medicine established under federal Roe v. Wade and federal government. Specifically, this bill authorizes licensed healthcare practitioners acting within their scope of practice to perform an abortion upon a patient within 24 weeks of the commencement of pregnancy. And it allows these procedures to be performed after 24 weeks if it is the reasonable and good faith professional judgment of the healthcare practitioner that there is an absence of fetal viability or if the patient's life or health is in danger. Some people have talked about this as some radical expansion of the reproductive rights in the state. I want to emphasize that the science proves. We are talking about ensuring that we have the laws that allow a healthcare provider to save the life of a woman, to allow a healthcare provider to limit the pain and suffering of having to deliver knowing that the fetus is going to not survive, to protect the women from actually facing the risk of long-term life-altering damage to their bodies because they can't get the health care that they have the right to under law because of our laws. This is the only health care process in the state of New York that is still under our criminal statutes, not under our health care law. This legislature, as has been established by Supreme Court decision, should not be making these decisions for women and their families. These are decisions that should be made by women, their families, and their health care providers. I urge this House to finally take a vote to allow modernized reproductive rights laws to enter our books so that we can stand proudly and say, we made sure our laws were equal for everyone. We made sure that we did not continue our tragic history over multiple decades of failing the women of New York State and their families and the healthcare providers who know what needs to be done and have to tell women, I'm sorry, you'll have to leave New York State to to get the health care you need, and I hope you can get that done before it's too late. And you know what, Mr. President? As we know, sometimes it's not before it's too late. So I urge this House to take a vote in favor of this amendment today, and I want to make clear that a vote no is a vote against women's health and rights and protections. And I would find it untenable to explain to the public why I was not voting in support of this today. Thank you, Mr. President.